set for the rematch on November 19th, as the Mission Axiom sits on the proverbial top of the mountain waiting for someone to try to knock them off. The Anaheim Bullfrogs looked good in the opening round with wins over the Hollywood Dream and Arizona, but came up small in primetime, taking an 8-0 pounding on national TV. The Bullfrogs are looking for redemption and a share of the MLRH West lead. The MLRH action continues November 19th.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the rinks here in Irvine, California for RollerHockeyTV.net's live broadcast of Major League Roller Hockey. I'm Adam Steele alongside MLRH Commissioner Doug Jones. Jonesy, how are we doing today?
Pretty good. A week away from Thanksgiving. First of all, I want to wish all our viewers all across the world and the U.S. a very happy Thanksgiving next Thursday with your families. And we're glad you could join us tonight for the special edition of RollerHockeyTV.net.
Got some big games tonight, Jonesy, but let's first start with the top of the ladder. Let's talk about the Mission Axiom.
Mission Axiom, what can I say? Proverbial powerhouse. Right now, they're still undefeated. They've won both their games this afternoon, and I'll tell you what, I'm really looking forward right now to the game between the Arizona Arsenal and the Mission Axiom.
That should be a fun one. Well, now dovetailing right in, what do you think about the Arsenal's chances?
Well, I think right now the Arsenal are 2-0 on the day. Dan Maxwell's been behind the bench doing a great job. The Arsenal has a lot of depth. They're a young team. They've got legs. One of the big things that I like about them is that everybody plays. Danny uses full effect of all three of those lines. I think they're going to give the Axiom a big run for their money tonight.
Well, it should be interesting from top to bottom, from Jared DeGroote, Dan Center. They even got this guy, Wolf Mansuzzi, who plays a couple shifts, and I think they got something stirring, so we'll see what happens there. But how about the Anaheim Bullfrogs?
Anaheim's been struggling a little bit. Stephen Campbell went down with a knee injury today, so Soupy out to you. Adam and I both sent our best. We hope you get well. Jay Russell said you do have to be to work on Monday. They came out, and I'll tell you what, the Arsenal outplayed them. It was a great game. Unbelievable goal by Chris Federigo. He roofed the puck on the backhand, which actually was the game winner. It ended up being a 4-3 game with an empty netter to seal it with the Arsenal. And the Bullfrogs have been struggling a little bit, so hopefully they'll put it together, and we'll see them play a great game tonight against the Hollywood Dream.
Well, the captain, Brian Steiner, definitely should hold things together for those guys.
Brian Steiner's a class act. He's a great leader on and off the floor, and we also send out our heartfelt wishes to his mother, who has just been diagnosed with leukemia. So we do want to send our wishes to you and hopes and prayer for your recovery and just for everything to go well with that.
Well, we'll be dreaming of good things. And speaking about dreaming, what do you think about the Hollywood Dream? They've had some ups and some downs. It looks like we're on the way down again.
Well, the Hollywood Dream's in a very difficult position. Obviously, you and I both know there are several players that are supposed to be here that for some reason just don't make it to the games. There's not anything that these guys that show up can do about it. But, you know, I do hope that these guys will show up. We do see the Sobhraj Najjars, Mike Najjars, Kevin Adams, Eitan Shavera, who is back in town and was supposed to be here tonight. We hope these guys will take this serious and show up because it's not fair to their teammates to have to play these games without them.
All right. Well, let's focus in on the standings. Let's take a look. MLRH.com is where you go. You check out all the up-to-date stats and standing. We got the Axiom at the top of the chart.
Axiom is 5-0 right now, and it's like the big kid on top of the mountain. Somebody come and knock me off. And I'll tell you, they're in first place. The Arizona Arsenal right now is squeezed up into second place, followed by the Anaheim Bullfrogs, who are in third, and then the Hollywood Dream in fourth.
Well, how about those leaderboards? cards, though. Who we got at the top of the leaderboard right now? A little guy named Tommy.
Tommy Tyler for the Mission Axiom. Big surprise defenseman. Smart player, though. Knows when to jump into the hole, knows when to do it. Tommy has actually been leading us in scoring. And then right behind him is Joaquin Chavera, who had that great night. Joaquin scored the only hat trick of the opening night, October 29th. Therefore, MLRH donated $25 to St. Jude's Children's Hospital. Joaquin couldn't be here tonight to accept the check, but the donation was made in his name. After that, we've got two of the Bullfrogs, Joey Laricchia, and then we have Charlie Middleton, who helped round out Scare. And then, as we were talking about, Aaron Moss, the Cy Young leader, 6 goals and 1 assist. I'll tell you what, proverbial power forward, though. I mean, Mossy's a hard guy to push around on the rink.
Yep, he started playing Major League Roller Hockey all the way back in 2000 for the Colorado Crush, won the championship that year against the Marple Gladiators in Philly, PA. I was there for that game, and he was a powerhouse then, still a powerhouse now.
And right now, our feature game of the night, we're looking at the Anaheim Bullfrogs and the Hollywood Dream. Again, I think right now this is a good game for the Bullfrogs to get a little bit of their credibility. Not the credibility, but get their confidence back. They need to play the Dream. The Dream not having a big lineup tonight. And obviously, I think the Bullfrogs capitalize on that. Should be a good game for Anaheim. But again, the Dream's been battling hard all day. So we'll see who comes out and prevails in that one.
Speaking of seeing who's going to come out and prevail, we're going to see that and the game after as well in just a few moments, right after these commercial words.
T10 Revolt, featuring a true vented tongue and an anti-sting lace bite insert. With airflow like this, your feet will always stay dry.
Dude, why'd you stop?
T10s are dry.
I don't think they're dry yet.
Come check out the Axiom T10 Revolt for yourself at the NARCS 2011 Finals.
Things right now is we're getting an idea and our viewers that missed the Joe Cook retirement night. Obviously, great opportunity. I know we cut into the middle of it. There was another 30 seconds that we missed, but it was a great night, great opportunity for Joe and his family. Joe coming out on the floor. I had the great opportunity of being connected with Joe since 93. Joe and I have spent a lot of time together. He's a class act, his family, his wife, his kids. It was just a terrific night to make sure that they all were honored the way that they should have. And what'd you think about the whole thing, Adam?
Oh, I agree. It was a fantastic night. I mean, not only just to see Joe, but to have everybody come out and, you know, support the fact that we're, you know, retiring not just a great guy on the court, but a guy off the court. It's just been a fantastic, fantastic evening.
Yeah, and then obviously the Mission Axiom and the Anaheim Bullfrog game there. And boy, I tell you, the Axiom just blew the Bullfrogs right out of the water. And earlier there, we had the situation with the Hollywood Dream, which beat the Arizona Arsenal 8-6. So that was just a great night. And I think everybody that was a part of it got to enjoy.
We'll be right back. Axiom T10 Revolt, featuring a true vented tongue and an anti-sting lace bite insert. With airflow like this, your feet will always stay dry.
Dude, why'd you stop?
T10s are dry.
I don't think they're dry yet.
Come check out the Axiom T10 Revolt for yourself at the NARTS 2011 Finals.
All right, Adam Steele here live with you from the rinks in Irvine, California, as we join the Hollywood Dream and the Anaheim Bullfrogs in progress right now here at the rinks in Irvine, California, hanging out alongside Doug Jones as the Dream just tied it up on the power play 1-1.
Yeah, well, obviously, we talked a little bit about Brian Steiner in our opening there. Stein's got the game-opening goal, and answering back right there for the Hollywood Dream on the power play was Josh Manis. I mean, nice goal, too. Backdoor pass. All he had to do was tap that thing home.
Yep, another great start for the Dream. We'll see how it holds up as the Bullfrogs do have the larger bench as they win the draw now. They're going to wheel back with it. Bullfrogs coming off a subpar opening game live on RollerHockeyTV.net just a couple short weeks ago as they walk in the zone now. This is Steiner with a drive. He scores. What a snipe, Jonesy.
Tell you what, Brian Steiner, he's got a lot to prove right now. He's got the C on. I know he has not been happy with his performance today. Got a lot on his mind with his mom. And again, we send our wishes to her. So Stein's just balls the twine, as we would say there. Give the Bullfrogs a 2-1 lead over the Hollywood Dream.
If they keep answering back like that all night long, the Bullfrogs will definitely turn their opening couple games around. And here's Steiner off the draw. Now he's going to work the puck across. It's going to be up through center. As they're going to walk through onside now and into the zone. Another drive. That's going to be a save in front, and it's going to be no rebound. All right, at this time, we are going to head off for a commercial with 15:10 left to go in the first half. The Bullfrogs got a 2-1 lead, and here we go for a commercial break.
JR DeGroot are going to be your guests for the rest of the period.
Okay? All right. Welcome,
Hawaii.
Did you get the skates?
Yeah, you plus crazy lights, just like you said.
Excellent. Soon the championship will be ours. All ours.
Show your commitment to the game with the U-Plus Crazy Light from CCM. Get your fit on.
Adam Steele back with you here live on RollerHockeyTV.net. Bullfrogs won the draw, and they're going to work back into their own zone. This is Brian Steiner looking to walk the puck out. He's over the red line in on the left wing side. Try a drive, big save in front. Dream's going to look to corral. Work up the wing, and they're negated there by the Bullfrogs forechecking. Now is the Dream going to walk out now on the left wing side. He's going to try a drive, gets deflected out of play. 13:57 left to go, and the Bullfrogs hold on to a 2-1 lead. Right now, we are going to be joined by Arizona Arsenal coach Dan Maxwell and Arsenal forward J.R. DeGroot. Gentlemen, welcome aboard.
How you doing?
Hey.
What do you guys think of the action so far?
Warming up. Not bad. Early in the season. Getting all the cobwebs out.
J.R., how's things going? How was the trip up from Arizona?
Well, it was a long drive, but we had a good time. We're glad to be here and it's not raining.
All right, now we got the Dream trying to work it out, and they have a two-on-one rush, and the shot is going to be a save, and the rebound's going to be corralled right there. So at this time, we've got a few moments here. We can talk to Dan. What's your involvement with State Wars now?
I'm one of the national directors. I do a lot of tryouts. You know, McManus has us going around to different states and making sure that we get as many states involved and get kids involved. And we're pretty excited this year. It's going to be in St. Louis, a new venue for us. And we're getting a lot of buzz about it. So we're pretty all excited to get it going here.
Yeah, it's all announced. You guys can check that out. You can follow State Wars online. Also have a fantastic Facebook site that you can check out as well. Follow State Wars. And how was State Wars soccer? Talk to us about that. I know we can dovetail off the hockey side, but you were a big part of State Wars soccer this year.
Yeah, that was one of those using the same template as we do in inline hockey and go over to soccer. And the event was very good. And as we started off in Milwaukee, have about eight states involved. We're going to try to do it again this year. And I'm pretty excited about the growth of it. Like I said, it's new for us, just like anything. You know, you start off, you grow with it. So we planted a seed, and we think it's going to grow from there.
All right, awesome. Continued success with that, as always. State Wars has been a fantastic program in our sport for many years, and will be now in hockey and soccer for years to come. As we're back to the action now, the Bullfrogs control in their offensive zone. Look for an opportunity. It's going to be stuffed in front, kicked away to the left wing corner. Now the Dream try to corral there. There's the play along the wall now. Swings it all the way out to the left wing side, and this is Steiner with a drive, and it's blocked down in front. Dream still looking to clear out of a bad situation. Nifty backhander off the bar in front, and it is covered. Steiner is still a little bit stunned, but while he's stunned there, we're going to take a commercial break. We'll be right back.
What do I control? I don't control the bumps and the bruises, the crowd, or who covers me. I don't control the bounces, the shootout order, or for that matter, what happens outside the rink. There are a lot of things in life I don't control. But then again, there are some things that I do.
Back at you live here, RollerHockeyTV.net's coverage of Major League Roller Hockey. Adam Steele here along with guest commentators J.R. DeGroot and Dan Maxwell of the Arizona Arsenal. As this is Brian Steiner going to walk out of his own zone and move the puck up the left wing side now. Bullfrogs look to set up in front. It just goes off the goal to sitting there in front, and the Dream's going to work out now. Walk up now, 2-on-2. In front, a little miscommunique as the Bullfrogs now look to lead it out. Steiner checked off the puck and gets it right back to his own teammate. After being whacked in front, it goes still there. Looking to get it in front as the Dream clear almost into their own net. Now a try in front. He shoots and he scores. Short side goal there. JR, you scored a few like that.
Yeah, just a few.
And the Bullfrogs are going to jump up, 2-goal lead now, 10:15 left to go in the first half. It's 3-1, Anaheim. Anything you see out there going to help prepare the Arsenal, Dan?
Hopefully slowing down with all these games, so that's what we're hoping. We're starting to hit our tanks a little empty, but we're going to try to rally here and get a little inspiration and come out this last game against the Juggernauts.
All right, Larikia's shot is going to fly high and wide as the Dream looks to corral, but there is a Bullfrog lurking behind the net. They maintain possession after they're checked off the puck now. The Dream still trying to gain possession. And this is Chris Raveling looking to work it out. He's going to slow things down a little bit. And now played in off a big hit. Dream still taking possession there. And now the Bullfrogs get it back. They're going to walk in and hold things up as they get in the zone. Going to be worked down in the far side corner. Shot in front, just deflected up. Dream going to look to break down. They have a 3-on-2 opportunity. Let's walk back to Raveling. Moves across, shot off the post, deflected in, and the Dream get one back. Nice little 3-on-2 there by the Dream to get one back. And at this time, we're going to head out for another commercial break. We're back now as the Bullfrogs have won the draw and coming in firing. And wow, what a hit there by Joey Larikia. Bullfrogs look to maintain possession as they walk out of the left wing side with it. And big defensive play there by the Dream defender, number 89. That's Chris Raveling. So their goaltender tries to slide it up. And here's Raveling now. He's going to walk out. Trying to start a little 2-on-1 rush, and after getting slipped up, they're going to have a 3-on-1 now for the Dream. And a cross, and it's slipped away, and that's going to draw a penalty. Opportunity coming up for the Dream as they look to maintain possession, but the Bullfrogs are going to touch up there. And interference is going to be the call. And the Dream will head on a power play. Speaking of power, we got Jared DeGroot, power forward here, from Hawaii, we might add. I'd like to ask you a little bit about how hockey has grown in the state of Hawaii.
Well, I started playing on an outdoor rink, you know, out in the sun. And Richard Pentecost just put up Kiha. It's a two-rink facility out in Oahu, and kids are really loving it.
Happened to get a chance to preview that facility just a few times. I actually caught the Arsenal out at an event out there just a What was it, back in May?
Yeah, that was the Raw Arsenal. We were wearing our Phoenix Dragons jerseys. We never had anything together. But that was a good time. We had a good time in Hawaii.
Well, looks like you had a few things together. I mean, you did play in the Men's Platinum Division, and you guys also played in the Narch Pro Division, which I thought was fantastic. I thought you guys did a really good job out there.
Yeah, thank you, thank you.
Modest guy. Steiner now in with it, shorthanded. A little floater gets stopped as the Dream look to recoup as they set up their power play opportunity. Walk into the zone now, a little 3-on-2 and a fake, and now a shot right through, and the rebound in front, and it's in. It's called in. It is called in. It's a tie game. Gabe Ruiz, the Hollywood Dream, now knots it up at 3. .625 left to go, first half. Penalties do cost you in these games. You know a few things about penalty killing, right?
Yeah, a few. I have a few shorties. Oh, yeah.
Yes, the modest talk from Arizona's own J.R. DeGroot, ladies and gentlemen. Well, the Bullfrogs look to answer back a little bit as the shot gets deflected off into the corner and goes into the netting. 5:56 left to go. We got a tie game here in the first half. Four-on-four action now as we're going to head off to a commercial break.
What was that up there? I said wait for backup. You could have gotten us both killed.
Crazy, come in.
This is Zach.
We got action in the crease. We need you up here.
On it, coach. Listen, man, I know your thing is explosive speed, but you really need to cool your jets.
Oh, great, I spilled my coffee.
Back at you now as the Bullfrogs ahead now 4-3 with under 5 to go in the first half as the Dream look to corral the puck behind their own net. Sneaked away in front now, taken back by the Dream as they're going to break 2-on-2. This is Raveling. Steps inside, loses possession, gets a shot on net as he's falling over. Puck now played into the corner. Now across. There's the Bullfrogs now. A little 3-on-2 into the offensive zone. Stepped in and shot off the side of the net. Corral there now. In front. Shot. Save. And it goes over the net. Now as the Dream look to play the puck down. Icing will be waved off. As the Bullfrogs look to corral right there. And they walk out of the zone now. In front, a little dribbler. Now still in front, bouncing. That's corralled there by the Dream as they're going to walk out. Pass now. Off the wall. Is onside. Down in front. Shot. Save. And no rebound there. .343 left to go. First half. 4-3 lead for the Frogs. Ruiz is going to win the draw for the Dream now. Nifty little move and back over. And the pass is miscommunicated. Now here's Larikia. He's in alone. He scores. Little miscommunication for the Dream, unfortunately, went bad. And now the Bullfrogs have hopped up to a 5-3 lead.
Myrtle Beach, this is Johnny Rock, owner of the one and only Kiss Coffee House right here at Broadway at the Beach. Family owned and operated, the award-winning Kiss Coffee House, voted best coffee house on the Grand Strand, is home of the world-famous frozen Rocketino, available in 13 rockin' flavors. We also have authentic Kiss memorabilia, including costumes and guitars straight from the band themselves, as well as exclusive Kiss merchandise available only at the Kiss Coffee House, including t-shirts, panties, coffee mugs, shot glasses, and much, much more.
The Kiss Coffee House,
the only coffee house in the world where you can rock and roll all night.
And drink coffee every day.
And back to the action now, under 3 minutes left to go. First half of play, the Bullfrogs have the 5-3 lead as they walk over the red line now. Tripped up, and the Bullfrogs are still going to corral. Walking in, 3-on-2, a shot, safe, then a rebound. Still in front of the net as the Dream look to set up now. And they're going to throw the puck up the right wing. It was going to go down, but now icing has been waved off. It's going to be played up the other way. And the Dream going to look to come out of their own zone. First, they're going to walk back with it up the right wing side. And wow, what a big hit there right at center ice. Got to keep your head up in this game as the Bullfrogs look forward. That shot gets deflected. Oh, a little bit of his own medicine right there as his back, a toe save by the netminders. They move up the right wing side now. The Dream have to gain the red line in order to move the puck, and the pass was off a glove and into the far corner now. Another big hit as the Bullfrogs stepping up on the physical play. This is Steiner now as the Bullfrogs and Dream both look to get a change. Bullfrogs putting the pressure on, playing the body, trying to wear down this Dream team that they have a two-goal lead on. Now as they walk in on the left wing side, pass in front, and they score. Change of pace, real important. The Bullfrogs are taking it to the Dream. 1:16 left to play first half, and now the goal lead is 3. Tough spots like this, JR. What do you do when you're down by 3 goals?
Got to keep your head in it. You got to keep going. This Dream's got heart. They've been out here for 3 games. They were missing a bunch of bodies earlier. They're still going at it, though. Still hitting hard, still shooting.
They come back down now with a shot. Big save by their netminder. They're going to walk up on the right wing side now. Shot off the bar. And the Dream look to corral there. Dream trying to maintain possession now. The Bullfrogs are going to intercept with a man wide open in front. Was not seen. Now in front. Some of these guys just have eyes in the back of their heads. How do they do it? You have eyes in the back of your head, JR?
Two or three.
Now intercepted, a little one-on-one here. Shot deflected off the defender. And pass trying to flip it over the net, just ended up flipping it over the roof almost now. As we wind down the last couple seconds, 6-3 is your score. Bullfrogs are up after the first half. And now we're going to send it back to Doug Jones in the studio.
TV.net studios. I'm Doug Jones, joined by my special guest, the head coach of the Arizona Arsenal, Dan Maxwell. Dan, thank you for taking a couple moments to join us this evening.
You bet.
One of the big things you want to talk about is obviously Rich Garvey was out here with us opening weekend. The team, while they did go 0-3, I thought they showed a lot of promise. Obviously, three lines, big bench, a lot of depth. You show up today, so far the team has been unblemished with a 2-0 record. What do you attribute that to?
Well, first of all, they pay their dues the first game. I mean, second time you come out here, you know, you're going to make adjustments. So, like you said, it's all we can do is just get better and better and better.
And they have. The Arizona Arsenal showing some tremendous poise and confidence. Chris Federigo, I was talking about that goal a little bit earlier. That backhand goal was just amazing. If you had a chance to watch it, he actually roofed the puck under the crossbar on the backhand. It was a great goal. And Chris, no stranger to the East Coast Hockey League, playing for the Toledo Walleye at one point. So congratulations to Chris. But what's your game plan against Mission? I know Adam Steele touched base with you on it just a little bit. You got Mission. They're big. They've got a lot of depth. They're hard. They can play any kind of game. What is your plan when you go into that?
It's not giving them a lot of space and time. I mean, they're good with space and time, so we want to keep on them and maybe, you know, get sticks in their way, get bodies in their way, you know, let them panic maybe and let us get a couple odd man rushes. I mean, that's all we can really do is probably play the best defensive game as possible.
And obviously, as we know, you wear two hats. Not only do you coach for the Arizona Arsenal, you started up, once again, you're involved in a tremendous outpour of youth hockey that's building up in Arizona. Tell us a little bit about that, Dan.
Yeah, well, what we're trying to do is get roller hockey. I mean, you know the roller coaster ride of roller hockey in the past, and stuff like this we're doing here, and getting the youth back. I'm training right now, cross-training. We're the only program in Arizona that does ice hockey and roller hockey as part of the old program called Arizona Runners. And we're very excited about that. So we have 150 kids with inline skates now, training in roller hockey. We actually have some of the Arsenal guys come out during practices to get them going. So we're looking to maybe get something like this going in Arizona, let the kids see it, you know, and get exposed to it, how fun the game is. You know, both you and I have been around the sport a long time, played and also doing it, and we know how fun it is. So we just want to give that experience to the youth that we have in Arizona and get a kind of a kick in the butt again.
Absolutely, and no better person than you to do it. But what's your thoughts this year? Tim McManus makes a major announcement. State Wars 2012, St. Louis, Missouri. What are your thoughts on that?
Outstanding. I mean, you know, it's a different venue. I don't think in a long time how many national finals have been in St. Louis in a while. So we're very excited. The people at the Recplex, I think it's called, in St. Louis right now are very excited. They came out, they watched it. We're very excited. I mean, you can go to statewarshockey.com and check out the actual photos of the facility. St. Louis is a huge roller hockey pocket, as we know it already. So I'm sure they're going to be coming out in hordes. So let's make sure these other states can compete with them. Let's see what they got.
Well, Pat Maroon, for example, now with the Anaheim Ducks, who's playing in their farm system, American Hockey League, he's a product of St. Louis hockey. Obviously a great town, as you know. Not only that, but summertime is perfect. It's baseball season.
Oh, yeah.
So I know that one of the great things with State Wars and Tim McManus has always been he treats his troops so well. They catch Major League Baseball games and everything else. Dan and I had the pleasure of actually being roommates one year. Had a great time. State Wars, it's a tremendous product. If you haven't signed up or even tried State Wars, make sure you go to their website at www.statewarshockey.com. Dan Maxwell has been our guest for the first intermission here, RollerHockeyTV.net Studios. We return you after these commercial messages to the Anaheim Bullfrog Hollywood Dream Hockey Game.
All right, we're back here with you. RollerHockeyTV.net's coverage of Major League Roller Hockey. We willed into the second half already. Just about a minute in, the Bullfrogs still holding on to that 6-3 lead. As Flores hands the puck off to the linesman, we're going to get ready for another draw.
When I tell you, I get you a special guest, I always say, we're gonna have you have the opportunity to talk to the proverbial power forward that we were talking to about a little bit earlier in our roundup about the Mission Axiom. So Aaron Moss is going to join us at this time. You get a little chance to – actually, Aaron won an MLRH championship in 2002, I believe.
Well, actually, not to correct the commish, but was actually 2000. It was with the Colorado Crush, and I happen to know a bunch of the guys you played with, guys that included previous MLRH champion in 97, Mike Vickerman, and a couple other guys. Aaron, welcome aboard.
Hey, how's it going?
Oh, it's going good. How's your night so far?
It's going good. A couple wins for us tonight, so it's always positive.
And what are you looking forward to tonight?
Stay undefeated. We're going to take this one all the way, too.
All right. Sounds good, you know. Big big season last year. You guys came out with the 10 grand. How'd you spend it?
I think I bought a TV, actually. It was pretty nice.
Well, speaking of buying things like that, well, there goes another goal. In the back of the nets for the Bullfrogs, they jump up by 4. And speaking of that, it was number 44, Charlie Middleton. And at this time, we're just about 2 minutes in with a 4-goal lead for the Anaheim Bullfrogs. We're going to head off to another commercial break.
Axiom T10 Revolt, featuring a true vented tongue and an anti-sting lace bite insert. With airflow like this, your feet will always stay dry.
Dude, why'd you stop?
T10s are dry.
I don't think they're dry yet.
Come check out the Axiom T10 Revolt for yourself at the NARCS 2011 Finals.
All right, we're back with you here, and just as we get back on the air, Cam Prime throws in another one for the Bullfrogs, and they're up. 17 minutes left to play. They're up 8-3. Just reminiscing on the break here with Aaron Moss from the Mission Axiom, going back to that 2000 championship season. So anybody else's name you want to bring up?
Yeah, there's a lot of good guys on that team. Derek Thiede comes to mind, Dougie Fetz. See Stuber and Tim Hannon, all my boys out in Colorado. So they're still playing somewhere out there, playing in the old guy league, but they're still looking good. 35 and older, you know.
Well, flashing the leather there is Flores. He turns one back. We'll look for another draw, but definitely some good stuff to reminisce about. I was in Philadelphia for that game, and I tell you, that was a battle. What was the final on that? Was it like 10-9 or 10-8 or something?
Yeah, I think it was a little bit closer, 6-5, I want to say. But, yeah, it was definitely a battle. I think, let's see here, Yoder and those guys were on the team at the time. So a lot of big boys out there at the time, and we came home with the victory.
All right, shot deflected away as Steiner's going to corral the rebound, throw it off of Flores, and now the Bullfrogs look to take as this is Larakia. He's going to move it in front, and Prime's there to tip it. It just goes wide, and the Dream are going to look to move up the right wing side. Now pass, miscue, but still the Dream keep possession, and it's thrown in front, just trickles a bit wide. And now the Bullfrogs look to walk out with it. Steiner warding off a check there now as the Dream pick it up, and they'll move down their left wing side. Here's a 3-on-2 now. Thrown back in front, wide open, and just chipped off his stick. Played into the wall now. Still with possession. And glove down. The Dream will maintain there. Fire a shot, just a bit wide. And another in on goal, deflected away by the skate of a Bullfrog. And it'll play up the right wing side now. as Anaheim looks to step out. Saucer pass thrown in for Larrikey. He's going to fire it wide. Now passed in front, intercepted and given just past the onside stick of Chris Raveling, and the Bullfrogs fire it away. Dreamer going to corral there. This is Ruiz. And as he moves the puck across, they're going to walk back with it, and the Dream's going to set up there. 12:47 left, second half. Dream down by a score of 8-3. Anaheim now intercepts. They're going to corral there in the offense's corner. In front and just miscued. They're going to look to regroup now. What was it like playing against Anaheim a couple of weeks ago here?
Yeah, I don't know. They should have brought a little bit more of that last game, I'll tell you what. But, you know, we're a good team. We've been playing together for a long time. They'll get it together.
In front, a try just a bit wide. Back in front. It goes in. Bullfrogs jump. All right, we're back with you live, and while we were away, the Dream actually snuck one in down on the other side past goalie Rob Suddeth, and now the score is 9-4 with 10:45 left to go as Anaheim in their offensive zone now. And Raveling throwing the body on to Brian Steiner a little earlier, and then in front right there, saved by Flores. The Dream getting a little more physical. Playing up to Anaheim's level. And we'd like to thank Aaron Moss for stopping by, of course. He's got to go get ready for the next game as the Axiom take on the Arsenal. Have fun out there, Aaron.
All right, guys. Thanks a lot. Have a good one.
As we got MLRH Commissioner Doug Jones now sitting in with us here. 10 minutes left to go in a 9-4 game as the Dream's going to walk in there. Picked off in front, and the shot goes just a bit wide and hit the back of the net. This is Steiner.
I think one of the things with the Dream here, got to give them a lot of credit right now. They're battling. This third game of the day, they're a little fatigued, tired, but they're still going hard to the net.
And the Dream, like we said, we're picking up the physical play, meeting Anaheim toe for toe. Now they got to get them on the scoreboard. Down 5 with 9.5 left to go now. In front, and it goes in.
Charlie Middleton buried that one. I don't know if you watched Charlie play or had the privilege to watch him play. Kid's got hands of gold. He was with the Revision Vanquished when they won the NARCH Championship back in 2008. One of the big things that I like about Charlie is he uses the time and space that he's given so creatively. He got that puck. He waited for the goaltender to open up his legs. Just made it look easy.
And the thing about Middleton is you really underestimate him. He looks like a big guy. Looks like he's going to do a lot. And a lot of people just underestimate him. Definitely a great player here in this game. Dream now in their offensive zone as they're going to look to try and snag one back. Maintain possession. In front, a little chipper on goal. Sutta steers it away, and the Dream come back with possession. They're going to walk it across to Ruiz, who's going to walk in. Send one off the defender and into the corner. Bullfrogs look to get it out. They'll try and walk up the left wing side. Intercepted down, thrown across. Steiner, the only one there, as he's going to wheel back and regroup for the Frogs.
Captain Brian Steiner, I'll tell you what, he took the loss earlier today, the Axiom, very personal, and it's great to see him rebound. The last two games he's played tremendous, so great to see Brian back out there, and he's such a big guy. I mean, he's so hard to get around.
A couple guys are throwing the body in front now, and a quick goal by the Frogs.
Tell you, they're on fire right now. Chris Ellis, I believe that's a hat trick for him tonight. Ellis just joining the team. He wasn't able to be here opening weekend, but he's been a great addition, along with picking up Mike Henley, who made his debut earlier tonight. He played pro ice hockey in Germany, also played some junior A up in Canada, so he's wearing number 10. Bullfrogs have added some definite size and beef to the lineup.
Now off the draw, this is Prime getting held up by a stick of Gabe Ruiz, who's going to try and walk out of the zone. Not fooled there by the Bullfrogs' forecheck as they walk back in. A little 1-2 play that dribbles over Flores and poked into the net.
That's it. The MLRH mercy rule kicks in. It's an 8-goal lead, so this is going to wrap up the game. And obviously for the Bullfrogs, they really needed this for the confidence. So with the final coming here, 12-4.
Well, I tell you what, that was a very, very valiant effort by the Dream Squad with a short bench there and everything. But picking up the physical play will get them going. But let's head out for a commercial right now. We'll be back in just a few.
This is Georgie Barber of AKS Mission Empire. He's really good. And this is the Hornet Split. Is there a doctor in the building? I'm definitely having a seizure right now. No, seriously, call one. The Hornet Split's going to grip better and last longer using our patented M-Tech technology. What's a dog doing in the video? Weird. Don't believe me? Ask AKS Mission Empire, NARCH Division 1 champions. Get on the Hornet Split today because you do not want to make this guy mad.
TV.net studios on a very cold and chilly November night. I know I've got the Under Armour on feeling, but Brian Steiner, you're a little warm after that 12-4 victory. How'd it feel?
Felt good to finish on a good note. Definitely was a little frustrated coming in, perhaps a little cold since we haven't played for the last few weeks, but it's nice to be able to finish on a good note for sure. And to do it with authority was nice.
Yeah, obviously one of the things, you played Mission earlier today, 5-2 hockey game. Mission scored those three unanswered goals in the last 4.5 minutes. You guys played them tough down to the wire. So what were some of the things you were happy to see about today with the Bullfrogs?
Well, I tell you, it was nice to see that nobody really packed it in. And that was, for me, a really big big thing we could build off of for sure. Nobody decided to call it a day. And I tell you, you know, like I said, between being physically tired and perhaps, you know, giving up a pretty significant lead. And then, you know, it's easy to just kind of, you know, fold up, so to speak. But we didn't do that. We came back. We definitely were as gritty as we could be.
Well, and one of the nice things, you made some great additions today. Chris Ellis wearing number 8, and then obviously Picking up Mike Heinle. Did I say his name correct?
Yeah, Mike
number
10. Heinle.
Big boy out there, had some size, presence, very physical hockey player. Not scared to rough it and mix it up a little bit, which was great to see in that Mission hockey game. But then the Arizona Arsenal. Obviously, you guys started a little slow. They took advantage of you, but what a great comeback. You did try to make that. You guys almost knotted it at the end there with the goalie pull.
We'll be seeing them again.
That's probably the greatest words you can hear. And obviously, Brian, you and I having a little conversation. You just obviously having a very difficult time and just finding out that your mom now has been diagnosed with leukemia.
Yeah. I'm obviously hoping and praying for the best. Everybody that knows my mother, they know what an amazing, beautiful person she is inside and out. And I'd like to think that somehow we can look back one day and say, all right, I guess this was a blessing in disguise. But she's definitely in good spirits and definitely plans to beat this thing. And we're all definitely 100% behind her.
Well, I know myself and President Bill Rowey are already talking and what Major League Roller Hockey can do. As you know, we stepped in and did what we could to help Joaquin Chabert, and I know that we're looking forward to having a night here where it'll be a benefit night for your mom and her honor. And obviously, hopefully, if you're watching at home, our prayers, our thoughts are with you. We wish you nothing but hope and wishes for recovery. I know it's a difficult time, but it's great to see you here. Great to see you playing through it. And you got to look at the record now. The team picks up a win, drops two. You're in second place. What's it going to take for you to be able to beat that Mission Axiom team?
Well, I tell you, I think the biggest thing for us right now is to not change a thing in terms of our overall intensity and perseverance. We have a very good attitude even after those losses. It was definitely, we didn't go in the locker room beating ourselves up, but definitely trying to take something from those and learn from them. But I'd say the main thing is it'll be nice to get some supporting staff that, some noteworthy people such as Mishka Drury, obviously Mike Urbano, and who am I forgetting?
Derek Carlisle.
Yeah, Derek Carlisle. I mean, those guys right there, that's the kind of presence that we need. And I think that's going to make a big difference for sure.
How was it with Jay Russell on the bench today? Obviously, you get a coach now and a GM. Big difference in your style of play, the whole team style of play.
Yeah, it was nice. It was nice to be able to have somebody that, maybe when all of us are trying to figure out what to do, it's nice to have somebody that just says, hey, do this or do that. And I think it's a very nice thing to have just some basic direction and also some good energy, because he's definitely sitting back there just saying, hey, no worries, boys, trying to keep us, keep morale high.
So. Brian Steiner, captain of the Anaheim Bullfrogs, has been our guest here at the end of the Anaheim Bullfrogs as they defeat the Hollywood Dream tonight, 12-4. We'll return to the RollerHockeyTV.net network right after these commercial messages.
Axiom T10 Revolt, featuring a true vented tongue and an anti-sting lace bite insert. With airflow like this, your feet will always stay dry.
Dude, why'd you stop?
T10s are dry.
I don't think they're dry yet.
Come check out the Axiom T10 Revolt for yourself at the NARCS 2011 Finals.
Did you get the skates?
Yeah, U plus crazy lights, just like you said.
Excellent. Soon the championship will be ours. All ours.
Show your commitment to the game with the U plus crazy light from CCM. Get your fit on.
right, welcome back, folks. Adam Steele alongside Doug Jones here calling the Major League Roller Hockey action live in Irvine. Who we got working the game tonight, Dougie?
Well, it's great. We've got Shane Peters and Joe Lauer are the officials, and Lee Henson is the linesman for tonight's game. It's great to have such top-quality officials out here that have done a great job for us all day. So I can't say enough about the officiating. Players really appreciate the fact that it's cut down on the injuries and the amount of complaints I've been receiving.
Good to hear, as we have J.R. DeGroote jumping in, and a save by Redmond as Arizona and the Axiom are going toe-to-toe right now. And now DeGroote warded it off right there as it heads into Redmond. He's going to make a stop in the action.
Well, here they're going to be the keys for both teams tonight. Mission Axiom doesn't have their big bench, so Mission's going to have to really slow this game down and proverbially play, I hate to say, a cat-and-mouse game and try and lure Arizona in deep. Arizona, on the other hand, they've got a – you and I look at that bench, I don't think you can fit one more guy over there. Arizona needs to come at them full speed. They need to wear them down.
All right, we've got a little dribbler off the defender there on net as Redmond steered it away. And in front, a little mistake there, miscue by the Axiom as they're going to look to corral now. Arizona looking to try and step up the physical play as a puck gets knocked out of play, and we're going to have a face-off.
Well, Danny Maxwell right now, if you watch him, he's trying to match his lines, and he's pretty smart in what he's trying to do. He's trying to put Chris Federigo out there, number 93, trying to make sure that Chris is out on the floor, and I actually stand corrected. Danny pulled Chris off, so he has that opportunity to play against one of Mission's easier lines, not the top line. Playing against Aaron Moss, as you and I both know, is a very difficult task.
Oh, he did send out number 8, the Wolfman, as they call him. That's Joey Soucy. He won the draw for Arizona as they're going to look to break out of their own zone now. This is Soucy with it. He's going to play back for his defense. They're going to look to walk across, miscued off their own defender. Now they come out of the zone with it. Poked away by the forecheck of the Axiom. Arizona still with possession now. Here's Soucy looking to settle it down. He'll give way to the defense. Nifty play to get away from the forecheck now as it's played ahead. Big check by the Mission defense there. Another hit as Mission stepping up the physical play early now. Puck held in along the wing, and now Mission works back as they look to regroup. This is Riley. Riley going to look to work back now. Played back around and deflected.
I think it's great that Riley is strongly supporting Movember. He has the mustache going, somewhat of the Fu Manchu. Tommy Neer is out there with the Movember stash. It's great to see so many Mission guys playing with the stashes out here.
Apparently Arizona didn't get that memo. I see more beards than anything else. And that'll bring us now to our first commercial break.
What do I control? I don't control the bumps and the bruises, the crowd, or who covers me. I don't control the bounces, the shootout order, or for that matter, what happens outside the rink. There are a lot of things in life I don't control. But then again, there are some things that I do.
All right, we're back with you here. Nothing to score. 16-12 left to go. First half, Adam Steele, Doug Jones. Calling the action for you here as the Arsenal win the draw. Taking back Mission now with it. They're going to fire a try down and wide. Held there now as the Arizona defense slipping up just a little bit. Axiom going to maintain possession now. This is played back to Rizak, the original Movember stash.
Well, Chris Federigo's out there right now. And I talked to him a little before about Toledo Walleye and who he played for. May even have this team wrong that he was with in the East Coast Hockey League. He's a player to watch right now in the Arsenal. He does a lot of great things with the puck. if he gets it.
All right. This is Rezac now. He's going to walk out for a mission. He's going to fire a drive. And welcome to the game, Eric Hernandez, as he shuts it down now. We'll get a draw in his defensive left side. Coming about 5 minutes into the game, zip, zip. Do you think it would be like this, Jonesy?
Well, I think one of the big things with Eric Hernandez and what I like about him is his size and the fact that he comes out, he's a challenging goaltender. He doesn't wait for you to come to him. He forces you to make that first move. I kind of like that aggressiveness. We'll see how he holds up, though, against the Axiom.
And now the Arsenal going to move it now. This is center for DeGroote. He's going to fire just a bit wide now. Arizona going to look to regroup, and a miscue is going to go back into their own zone, and they're going to look to regroup there. Hernandez plays up for his defense. As they walk up the right wing side, and a drive deflected wide.
Chad Helvig, I don't know if you saw, he picked up a tremendous amount of speed along the boards here. Nobody on Mission could touch him.
Now Mission trying to gain possession, stolen away. This is center. Center now with it up for DeGroote on the left wing side. He's going to fire in, miscued there as Mission's going to break up. Got a chance for a 3-on-1.
That's so deadly when you don't complete that pass or get a shot on net. There it is. That's exactly what I'm talking about out here. Arizona Arsenal has a 3-on-2. The forward is tired, so he doesn't have his stick on the floor. His stick is tied up by a Mission defender. Immediately, you and I watch the puck squirt the other way. It's a 3-on-1, and Mission makes it 1-0.
There's MLRH's leading scorer, Tommy Tyler, out on the rink, and big plus for him. He gets Mission up on the board, 1-0.
I'll tell you, Mission's going to keep coming at them right now. They've tasted blood, and they're ready to get some more.
Now as they squeak away from the check, Mission's going to take possession of the puck now, wheel back, and this is Massey now with it. On the right wing boards, gives it back, and now Riley steers back for him. He's going to take a shot, and Hernandez is going to slow things down.
That's a good idea. You know, right now is a little helter-skelter out there for Arizona. Why not get a whistle, get a stoppage, give your boys a chance to talk to each other out there. What are we doing? Well, guys, we got to regroup. It's only 1-0. We're not out of the hockey game. Let's get our heads on straight. Let's win this faceoff and see what we can do.
Riley loses the draw to Franarigo, but he's going to play his man all the way into the corner and maintain possession. Throws it in front, and it goes off the defender as Arizona's going to break. Going to hustle for a 3-on-2 away from the Mission check. Shot fanned on there, and Mission's going to have a break. 3-on-1 if they hurry. This is near. He's going to move the puck inside. Back around to him. Sticked away by Hernandez. Now deflected away by Tui, and Arizona's going to have a break. Shot saved by Redmond.
Troy Redmond, I tell you what, he plays his angles so well. You really got to earn it to beat him.
Now Arizona going to work the puck back. They were going to change. But as the puck moves back, they're going to regroup and change the forwards instead. Arizona slowing things down a little bit. They're going to move the puck up the right wing side. And now back. This is Caruso. Caruso's going to wheel it back around for Tui. Tui avoids the check and moves to the right wing side.
Chad Helvig again, who I was talking a little bit about, number 9, he's got the puck right now. He's got some jets. Let's see what he does.
Helvig had the puck just sticked away from him. He's going to regain possession. Throw it in front. The shot in front now gets deflected away by the Mission defense. Axiom now going to walk. This is Stewart.
Outman attack again. We just talked about it.
Inside a shot just wide.
Pat McDevitt out there had his head down. He wasn't sure where to go with that puck, and as he looked up, you saw he had nowhere. Goalie came out and played the angle great.
Tui gets his pass intercepted by Stewart. Stewart looked to shoot, now looks to regroup. Rest of the guys are in the zone now as they work across. Soucy tried to play a check on. His Mission maintained front now.
Soucy looking like a toll booth there. I hope he left a quarter as he went by him. Tommy Tyler walked right by him, dropped the quarter in the toll. He's gone through that toll line.
Speaking of Tyler now, he's got the puck. The MLRH's leading scorer. Getting checked off and now has his pocket picked by Tommy Tui. He's going to move it ahead. Arizona's in. 2-on-1. A shot save by Redmond.
Not going to beat Redmond on an angle like that. If you watch how he came in, when he lifted up his head and looked, he was too close there. Wasn't able to get a good shot off. Troy Redmond is so perceptively, and I say the word perceptively, smart. Troy saw him with his head down. He takes those extra 3 or 4 feet, comes out. By the time the player looks up, he sees nothing but pads.
Interesting matchup here. Most of these guys in the Arsenal did play against Troy Redmond, and most of the guys from the Mission Axiom, all the way back in the Arch Pro Division in Hawaii, as a matter of fact, J.R. DeGroote's homeland.
Well, it was great to see Troy get traded to the Mission Axiom, and the Anaheim Bullfrogs picked up Mike Urbano, who just actually got done. Mike had surgery on his ears, so Mike wasn't able to be with us today. He's on the IR list, but Urbano, I still can't wait to see that battle when we see Mike Urbano and Troy Redmond squaring off against each other face-to-face with the Axiom and the Bullfrogs. So.
And we have seen it many times, many of these events. Those guys do go toe-to-toe, two of the game's top goaltenders right now. Both had opportunities to play for Team USA, I might add.
Double IHF gold medalists.
All right.
Actually, I think there's three of them on the floor right now. You got Mossy, you got Redmond, and Raf Rodriguez.
All right, this is Mission now. This is Rizak. He's going to move the puck back around to Massey. Massey back to Rizak as Mission looks to break out. Back to Massey on the right wing.
Love to play that game. They draw you in with those deceptive passes, and they just move the puck effectively. That's Mission's just, again, smart hockey team.
And we had a guy lose a bucket. He's going to head off the rink as they play in front. Hernandez is going to shut the play down, and we're going to head off to another commercial break. Back with you here, 9:02 left to go, first half. Mission has a 1-0 lead, tipped in front now. As Mission maintains possession, another offensive opportunity. And DeGroote's opportunity gets thwarted away by the Mission defense.
One of the things I like about J.R. DeGroote is he grew up, played all his most of his youth hockey on an outdoor rink in Hawaii on the Big Island. And he being out here and competing is just a testament to how hard he's worked to grow up and be a part of that program.
Now, big hit along the back wall by Sean Riley.
Finishing his hit. Huh? You got to love Riles when he comes in there and he has no issue. And Bill Rowey now, the president of Major League Roller Hockey, has decided to join us. So now we've made this twosome a threesome.
Bill, how are things going for you today?
Things are going wonderfully, Adam.
Bill Rowey, the man, the myth, the legend right there of Major League Roller Hockey. Whoa, ducked away from a hit there was Tyler. As Mission gains possession back, shot hooked away, and there's going to be a penalty call by referee Shane Peters. It's going to be a hooking call.
Cameron Caruso came in with a full head of steam, and what he didn't realize was the player he went to hit dropped to his knees. So he ended up, I think, he kneed him in the head. So it'd be interesting to see what referee Shane Peters is going to call here, but he is taking Cameron. All right, he's going to get him for a hook. So he must have pulled away from the play there and did a little hooking action.
Well, dangerous, dangerous, dangerous are the only three words I can think about Mission Axiom's power play.
Never want to give the Axiom a man up. This is how they win championships. These guys, you and I both know at NARCH, North American Roller Hockey Championships, the last 4 years they've been in the finals, what, three? Three out of those times? They don't give them the power play.
And speaking of their power play, here's Raf Rodriguez. He's going to throw across, drive by Tyler, and sticked away and thrown all the way down the rink.
So one of the great things about Major League Roller Hockey is on the power play, anytime the puck is cleared during a shorthanded situation, all the players must tag the red line and go back into the zone. Not simultaneously, each player must independently tag that red line, which, again, doesn't allow that hanger to get that long home run pass.
And Michonneau looking to set up as Rodriguez waits and fires, and it goes off the defender's stick. This is Aaron Moss. He's going to play it down and ask for it back. Now he's on the left wing side. He looks up top for Tyler. Touches for Rodriguez. Rodriguez now with it. Up top for Tyler. Tyler back to Rodriguez. He shoots and scores.
Boy, he didn't even hesitate on that. It's a sign of a goal scorer. If he went low short side on Eric Hernandez, Eric had no chance at all. He's moving side to side. Raff just takes a great shot. Doesn't even slow the puck down. And again, I was just about to talk about how he was a little bit off balance with his right skate. Now I understand why. He was getting ready to fire off that foot. Great play by Raff. Great pass by Tommy Tyler.
If he was a poker player, I guess you'd be doing pretty good.
Well, I've been in the poker room with you a couple times, and I'll never do that again. You and Manny Placencia, I'll never do that again.
All right, now Arizona looking to wheel back. Gain possession now and set up the break. Mission's fast and hard forecheck. Causes Arizona to throw the puck down, and this will be an icing against the Arsenal.
And illegal clearing again, Major League Roller Hockey, one of the great things about our rules. We have icing just like they do in ice hockey, professional ice hockey. The whole purpose of the illegal clearing is to not allow these players, when they're in trouble, to take that puck and just fire it down the other end and take away a great scoring opportunity. So with illegal clearing, now the players have to have that faceoff in the defending zone.
And after they win the draw, being pestered by Mission's forecheck, and Rizak takes the puck back, maintains possession for the Axiom. As he moves across for Massey, Massey looks up top for Stewart. Now he's going to walk across the line. Stewart patiently walks inside. He's going to fire, and it gets deflected by the defense. Arsenal really can't get things going out of their own zone so far, as Axiom now with it. Going to play down the left wing side. This is Stewart again. He's going to move up top. Massey steps inside the line and fires off the glove of Hernandez. And the Arsenal going to look to maintain a little possession.
Arsenal right now is playing a little scattered hockey. They're not moving the puck effectively. What they're doing with Mission is players are trying to chase the Mission players. You can't chase them around the rink. You've got to limit their space. You've got to limit their time. Hopefully Coach Dan Maxwell right now is having a conversation with his boys about what they're doing.
Agreed. And maybe a little 4-on-2 keep away in their own zone against the Mission forecheck is what they need to work on. Now Stewart fires a shot. It goes off of Hernandez's mask and lays in front for a second. He's going to fire again. It gets blocked by the defense of the Arsenal, and Mission's going to have to avoid the forecheck as this is Rodriguez.
Actually, a high stick of Pat McDevitt in front of goaltender Eric Hernandez. He hit the puck with a high stick, however, because an Arsenal player touched that puck and negated that high stick call.
Doug Jones as well as the officials right on top of that one. Too quick for my eye as the Arsenal now looking to work out.
And you were shaking your head about me being a referee.
Yes, this is Aaron Moss now working it back for the Axiom. As they're behind their own net.
You were punching the arm for that one. Shaking your head with Anthony Flynn and Keith Noll at a meeting. Telling you I'm refereeing kids' games and you're shaking your head.
Well, speaking of shaking my head, it looks like I'm going to shake it for another few moments as we head off to another commercial break.
What was that up there? I said wait for backup. You could have gotten us both killed.
Crazy, come in.
This is Zach.
We got action in the crease. We need you up here.
On it, Coach. Listen, man, I know your thing is explosive speed, but we really need to cool your jets.
Oh, great. I spilled my coffee.
All right, Adam Steele, Doug Jones here with you. 3:26 left to play in the first half. The Axiom have the two-goal advantage.
Talk about something here, okay? We're doing a webcast on October 29th. We're doing MLRH opening night, Joe Cook night, the whole thing. Adam Steele collectively fails to inform us that he's getting married. Now, when did this all happen?
Well, I keep my personal life out of it. I mean, this is, you know, this is hockey. We're broadcasting hockey. We're not broadcasting to tens of thousands of people that I'm getting married. That's not what this is about.
Now, you're a married man. You just came back from your honeymoon. You were down in Florida. How was the wedding? How did everything go? How's your wife doing? How's everything? Let's talk about it.
Oh, Heather's doing fine. I mean, I left Nevada for New Jersey, for New York, for Orlando, and I left Orlando this morning.
Is that a planned trip, or that just happened on a commercial airline?
No. I don't want to talk to that. Back to the action now. As Raf Rodriguez.
You're married, though. Life's good, right, Adam?
Oh, life has never been better. And now Rodriguez is fire. And Hernandez is going to shut the play down there. 2:29 left to go. 2-0 Axiom.
God bless you, Heather. That's all I have to say.
And if she's tuning in, she's probably going crazy right now. But
yes, her husband flew back from Florida today, landed in Nevada, and is here doing Major League Roller Hockey. I'll tell you what. Thank you, Heather, for allowing your husband to be here tonight. I know she wears the pants.
As Frederico gets his pocket pick.
You certainly don't.
This is Tommy Neer now. Play it across for Massey as he's going to walk back with it. He's got Rezac with him as he's pressured by the Arizona forecheck. He's going to walk behind his net. This is John Massey now. Up to Rezac on the left wing side, and Rezac going to walk in on the left. Now walk through center. He's going to fire off the defender into the corner now.
Did you at least register at Tiffany's?
I'm not going to talk about it anymore.
Well, it's secretive. What's going on? It's already been on TMZ. I mean, come on. There's nothing we don't know here.
I'm here to broadcast hockey, not my life. Tommy Neer now checking in at the red line.
Congratulate you one more time.
I appreciate that. Thank you, everybody. We are doing fantastic. As this is Massey, he's going to walk in and fire, and it went off of Hernandez. He didn't know where it went, but it went over the protective netting.
It's just such a great thing when you see Joel Lauer out here. I mean, Joel is a very competent official. As you know, he's on the pro ranks. He's been overseas, Japan, Europe. He's been everywhere. And it's so great to have his presence out here in Major League Roller Hockey this year, you know, along with Shane Peters. As long as you can get a sensor for Shane, Shane's a great guy. You just got to make sure somebody monitors what comes out of his mouth. But he does a fantastic job as a referee, too. And then, you know, we've got Hacksaw Lee Henson over here that I think he does just a great job, as they both do. And Henson working Narchin, always a very competent official when he's worked the Narch finals.
And Arizona getting a couple interesting offensive opportunities here. Another one miscued there. And now Mission going to take off an Arizona miscue. Rodriguez now with it. He's going to walk back in his own zone with 20 to play in the first half. Rodriguez looking now to kill some seconds and get out with a two-goal lead with 10 remaining now. Tyler with it. He's going to walk through. Fire off the crossbar, and it's going to go to the right wing side. Susie gets his stick whack there as the half comes to a close. Axiom 2-0 after the first half, and we're now going to head over to Doug Jones in the studio.
Commercial and then studio. All right, set the shot here. We got it. TV.net studios as we watch the Mission Axiom take on the Arizona Arsenal. So far, it's a 2-0 game as we saw Raf Rodriguez bury the puck on the power play with a great shot from outside the perimeter and inside the circle area, beating goaltender Chris Hernandez. I'm Doug Jones here in the studios. I'd like to remind everybody that Major League Roller Hockey will be hitting the Midwest December 3rd as we have our opener for the 2011 season. Looking forward to seeing the Motor City Assault, Chicago Carnage, and also the Buffalo Excitement, and the new New York Rock and Rollers will all be participating. We're waiting confirmation from the New Jersey Grizzlies, but we look forward to opening the season on December 3rd for the Midwest Division opener. And then Major League Roller Hockey returns to the rinks in Irvine on December 10th as it's Rob Laurie night. That's right, we'll be retiring number one from the Anaheim Bullfrogs. Rob Laurie will be here along with special guests again. Joe Cook and other former Anaheim Bullfrog teammates will be roasting Rob that night. Great night and opportunity. If you're a Rob Laurie fan or an Anaheim Bullfrog fan, don't miss it as we retire number one to the Raptors. Again, we'll return to action as the Mission Axiom and Arizona Arsenal are in a 2-0 battle. The Axiom up on top. Right after these commercial messages, you're watching the RollerHockeyTV.net network.
Myrtle Beach, this is Johnny Rock, owner of the one and only Kiss Coffee House right here at Broadway at the Beach. Family owned and operated, the award-winning Kiss Coffee House, voted best coffee house on the Grand Strand, is home of the world-famous frozen Rocketino, available in 13 rockin' flavors. We also have authentic Kiss memorabilia, including costumes and guitars straight from the band themselves, as well as exclusive Kiss merchandise available only at the Kiss Coffee House, including t-shirts, panties, coffee mugs, shot glasses, and much, much more.
The Kiss Coffee House, the only coffee house in the world where you can rock and roll all night.
Adam Steele, Doug Jones, back with you here. Second half action, the Axiom, the Arsenal.
And don't forget, John Massey wanted to get some TV time, so he deliberately got a penalty to come sit right next to us.
I wouldn't say it was too deliberate. Arizona threw a quick pass in front and took him down. And I do see a new goaltender in the Axiom Nets.
Nevin Iwatsuro, who last year played a tremendous amount for the Mission Axiom. Well, now Troy Redman. Great thing about Troy is Troy shows up to play every week. They're giving Nevin an opportunity in this game. And I think, you know, Troy playing the other two games today, he did play them. It's great to see Nevin get a chance to break in.
Well, with the Arizona Arsenal getting an opportunity on the power play now, Mission's going to take it down. This is a shorthanded opportunity now for the Axiom. And
Dustin Nowick got poetic hands, doesn't he? The way he chopped that puck into 1,000 pieces.
And Tommy Tyler walked in shorthanded and scored.
Very underestimated player, Tommy Tyler. He's got great skills, great vision, good hands, good speed. Knows when to jump, not when to jump. That was a perfect opportunity, and boy, did he bury that. 3-0. Now you got yourselves in a little bit of a hole here. The Arizona Arsenal is going to have to step it up.
Well, I need to hurry up quick because the seconds do tick away. They still have a little bit of a power play left.
Well, and again, the power play has to be utilized effectively out here. They didn't have any good puck movement. They weren't able to set up, and that's because primarily Mission forces them to make those quick passes they're not prepared to make.
After Tyler stepped down, Massey's been standing up in the box for the last 40 seconds waiting. Moss throws a hit now, and this is Frederico passing across for Tui, who's going to work it back, and as they push it out of the zone, the Arsenal is going to look to regroup.
Again, inexperienced, they're rushing their passes, they're not taking their time, coming in, getting the zone, setting the perimeter. Great hit over there, nice job. Aaron Moss, tell you, power forward, no doubt.
Now this is Tyler going around, he's going to throw the puck out of the zone as the power play expires for the Arsenal. Mission back at full strength now as Hernandez going to look to move the puck now. And Arizona's going to look to break.
Arizona needs to slow the game down a little bit. I think right now they need to slow down and regroup. Nice move.
Well, a little change of pace there from Tui. He's going to fire. There is no rebound from the new Mission netminder.
All right, smart. He's going to hold on to that puck, get the whistle, allow Mission to make that line change, and I think that's a very important part when you're looking at the game and the opportunity, and you want to make sure your teammates are all on the same page you are. Great play by Nevin to slow it down a little bit.
All right, out on the rink again is Chris Federigo as he's going to take the draw. Loses to the very experienced Tommy Neer, who's going to walk through center, up the left wing side now. On the backhand, he's going to move the puck all the way back up top. Rodriguez plays across now as Riley gives to Massey. Great puck movement here by the Axiom keeping possession.
This is where I start going, da, 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 da.
Well, like you said earlier, gotta knock the king off the throne.
Woo! Did you at least have Elvis at your wedding? Did Elvis come at least? You were in Vegas. Did he at least show up?
We had the wedding in New Jersey.
New Jersey. Ah, there we go. Hope
anyway.
Good fellas.
Back to the action now as Rodriguez's miscued shot is taken away by the Arizona defense. They're going to look to work it out of the zone now. Must maintain possession first.
Too many moves again. You've got to make that first pass. You can't hold on to that puck and try and skate through two of the Mission guys. You're going to beat the first one, but you're not going to beat the second one.
Again, Mission applying. Very difficult forecheck as Arizona picking up a little bit of the physical play. Mission still maintaining possession. This is Riley.
Did you at least see Mickey and Minnie while you were in Florida?
How could you miss them?
You went to Epcot. What was your favorite country in Epcot?
I don't want to say Canada. Question.
It's Canada. Did you have a beaver tail while you were there?
I won't get into that. This is Rodriguez.
Beaver tail's a patient.
In front, save Hernandez, and the Arsenal look to move quick. Getting around, this is DeGroote now. Walking and firing, and a save there.
JR had two other players with him, both in a triangle. All he had to do is drop the puck to the back man, surefire goal. Just Arizona's getting a little tired now. It's starting to set in.
A little frustration will do a lot for a lot of people, but this is Tyler now with it. Tyler walking in on the backhand inside now, thwarted by the defense. As Arizona's going to work it on. This is DeGroote with another opportunity. He's going to pass in front.
Little too deep.
And Tyler there with it. He's going to throw a chili dipper in, and he still maintains possession. It's across and just thrown in on net. What a save there, eh?
What a play by, and we were talking about Tommy Tyler. Right there, he just sacrificed his body. He knew the player was going to shoot the puck, so he, giving up the puck, slides directly into the path of the shot to block it. And, I mean, just after hearing about that player up in Canada, 16-year-old, who was hit in the throat and went to cardiac arrest and passed away, I mean, you and I both know, as people that have played the sport, it's something that when you do that for your team, it's absolutely courageous. And Tommy Tyler, no hesitation at all when he put his body in front of that shot.
Well, teamwork a big part of it. Laying yourself on the line is, wow, what you have to do sometimes, and that's a big part of it. Mission still maintaining possession, though.
I can tell you right now, if Ian Rezac has kids, they're going to be born dizzy after that hit.
And this is Rezac with it now, looking for a little bit of revenge. He's going to step between two Arizona players, in on his backhand across the goal mouth.
He's still seeing two goaltenders right now.
Mission now still maintaining possession. This is Massey with a shot deflected by the Arizona defense. Hernandez steers it aside. Now played into the boards. Arizona steers away with it now as they can hurry for a 3-on-2. A shot, save.
That was a Hail Mary there. That was, I tell you what, teeing the puck up from way outside there. That's a line change shot. I don't know what he was thinking there. Mike Sarter teeing that one up. But you didn't tell me, how was the Haunted Mansion?
The Haunted Mansion was a little bit better than it is out here in California, I must say.
So what made it different, though? So what did you think was different between this one and that one?
Well, it was definitely a longer wait, definitely a longer ride. I have to say a lot of the things. She loves the Tower of Terror.
Tower of Terror, the elevator ride that goes up and down. Yeah, that's a good time. Yeah, actually, the MGM Studios here, yeah.
It's actually
for Hollywood and the aliens in there. And,
yeah, well, actually, it's actually now called the Disney Hollywood Studios. They've gotten away from the MGM name.
Oh, they did. So the Wicked Witch, she still come out?
Yeah, she still comes out. And apparently we have a little We have a little discussion here between the players, but the referee has signaled the goal. It looked like Hernandez had it in his glove and possibly pulled it out.
What happened was it bounced off his glove, and Dustin Nowick there, who's wearing number 41, it looks like, from here, batted it out of midair into the back of the net. But this is where an official like Joel Lauer, I'm so confident in his abilities, if he waves it a goal, I'm not even going to bat an eye.
A little difficult to see from my vantage. You had the best view of it, of course. Mission comes down again, not batting an eyelash and firing another shot in on net.
Hey, you like my lines. Now you're going to steal them, huh? So when you did Epcot, did you do the whole thing in one day, or did you just you had to do it in one day, right?
Yeah, I've become...
From country, my favorite was Oktoberfest, and I loved Japan. That was great. Little sake, little beer, good time.
Yeah, we didn't get to experience every single piece of it, but we ended up doing the entire park, and we walked a little over 3.5 miles, so I did a 5K, Jonesy.
You did a 5K. 5K, that's, hey. Last time my wife and I were down there, we went to Universal. We had a great time. We loved it. We spent every day. We had a blast. Margaritaville in the morning, Margaritaville in the afternoon, and Margaritaville in the evening.
Oh, Mission picking up the physical play, and we got a contest here. It's going to be Frederico, and can't see who the Mission player is, but it looks
Dustin Nowick. And Nowick, I tell you, is a big fighter, man. Nowick was a fighter from he played junior for a little while and played some junior A. And right there, as we saw referee Shane Peters grab Chris Frederico, Nowick gave him an extra shot and a little hello. Chris Frederico there, I'll tell you what, stood right up. He didn't back down, and he threw him pretty well. It's not bad. Those two boys threw some punches. We actually had our first fight of the year here.
Well, Novak took a little exception to the extra whack in on Nevin there, and Frederico didn't back down at all. Like you said, he's going to be off to the box. We're going to see if the referees picked up the initial call, but we'll figure all this stuff out, and we'll be back in just a short while after this commercial. Adam Steele, Doug Jones here with you, and Jonesy's got the call.
James Seward joined us now. It's basically what happened there. Dustin Nowick, Chris Frederico, both are combatants willing to exchange punches. Major League Roller Hockey allows one fight per game per player. With the fight that was thrown, we saw some pretty good punches thrown. Both players absolutely making contact with each other, but Dustin Nowick was assessed the 10-minute misconduct because when the referee Shane Peters came in and took control of Chris, Nowick decided to take it liberty with that and throw an extra punch. So he received an automatic 10-minute misconduct, so he's done. We won't see him back out here for the rest of the evening.
Well, and with the initial call on Nowick, James Stewart has joined us in the box for the Axiom, and the Arsenal's on a power play down by four.
They'll be serving. James is serving the instigator because Nowick was the clear-cut instigator in that fight. So,
all right, the Arsenal now looking to set up on the power play. And Aaron Moss is going to have an opportunity now, shorthanded. Could be a two-on-one. He's going to try and walk in.
He tried to put that through the legs and then pull it out. It didn't. Fortunately, it didn't work.
And the Arizona bench getting a little. Wow, everyone's still jumping after that. Aaron Moss kind of got a stick on somebody a little bit late there.
You know, it's one of those things, again, where the spectators get a little emotional. We got one spectator here all day who's been somewhat emotional, and the referees are over here doing the best job they can. The guy's standing up screaming at the officials. It doesn't, you know, people at home should learn, and you and I both know, again, working for Narch and things like that, that doesn't help the situation. The referees are here to restore order and try to get things back to where they belong. So listening to that just didn't help anything.
All right, this is Rodriguez now. 2-on-1 with Near, shorthanded into Near. Dances around in front and just couldn't put it by Hernandez.
Near. The puck was loose in the crease area and nobody could get a finger on it. Let's see what they do now. They got an outman attack.
All right, center moves the puck to left wing side. Now back in front. And couldn't sneak it by Nevin.
I don't understand why he didn't make that back pass to the door. He was right there. Dan Center was there with a stick down looking for the puck. Now we got Mission again. Outman attack.
And now as the penalty expires, Mission now getting a 2-on-2 with Stewart with the puck now. Stewart avoiding the check, now down in the right wing corner. Stewart now walking behind the Arsenal net. Plays it in front for Rizak, and it happens to slide all the way back. The Mission's zone, and they're going to look to switch up their lines.
Well, the great thing about Ian Rizak is he doesn't get a lot of credit for what he does. He's a stay-at-home. He really doesn't rush the puck. I mean, we've seen him do it a couple times, but Ian is more of a stay-at-home player. He'll hold on to the puck. He makes that first pass, and he's one of those types of guys you always count on when the times get tough, the 2-on-1, 3-on-2. He's always one of those defenders that's back there.
And Susie, the big man now for the Arsenal, avoids a check from Rizak. He's going to fire the puck all the way out to Tui. Tui. Going to fire in a shot on net, and Nevin's going to grab that and hold on with 7:07 left to go in the second half. 4-0 still for the Axiom.
Did you at all get to check out the Country Bear Jamboree while you were there?
Oh, that was one I told her she had to see. Big Al's my favorite.
Big Al is still there. Blood on the saddle. I love Big Al.
And Caruso loses the draw. The Axiom going to walk out with it. This is Tyler now walking to the right wing side. Tommy Tyler stepping inside, got a little bit of room, fires it off the bar.
Boy, did he hit that crossbar. What a great deceptive move, too, by Tyler. Just again, you know, watch him play, and it's just the things he does, he doesn't get enough credit either for what he brings to the hockey game.
Rodriguez fires in front. That's off the equipment of Hernandez. The Arsenal going to look to walk it out now. This is Caruso. Caruso. Tries to move it across down low for Susie. Susie there. Big hit now. And Susie into the boards awkwardly. Looks like he kind of hurt his shoulder when he took the check there. He's getting back to the bench a little slow.
Arizona's really forcing their opportunities. They're not taking the time to work the puck as they did in the first period. Now they're kind of really guessing at what they're trying to do. They need to just slow down and, again, let things happen.
All right, Mission going to step back with it. This is Tyler for Rodriguez. Raff going to hold it now behind his own net. Walking slowly, trying to kill the seconds off the clock now. Holding on to a 4-goal lead. He's going to walk across the red. And again, Mission very patient.
The thing I love about Raff is if you watch him play, if you watch him at Narch, if you've seen what he does, he's an agitator. When he's out there, he just agitates the opponents on the other team. The best forwards, he just wears and grinds them down. And you just watch him there. Not steady, not overly effective with the puck, but boy, does he do a great job in setting that play up for that pass.
Arsenal, another offensive opportunity with a 3-on-1, and they threw it just to the outside of the net. Now, Ian Rizak, the Wiley stay-at-home veteran, going to set things up as Riley's going to take now for Mission. Move it back to Rizak as they play patiently behind their own net.
I'm still, boy, I tell you, those punches thrown in that fight, there were some roundhouse rights thrown there. Dustin Nowick got a couple in, but Chris Fratterigo really impressed me with how he stood his ground and threw right back.
Now Mission's chance, stopped by Hernandez once again as the Arsenal look to gain possession. They cannot in their zone. Mission's got a 2-on-2 opportunity. As they look back, another shot gets fired in. Hernandez is going to hold on there with 4:20 to go.
And now at 4:20, you know, Mission's got a pretty good size lead, so they don't have anything to prove. It's just more or less a game of keep away. They want to maintain good puck control. Now, if I'm Danny Maxwell, I'm going to shorten my bench a little bit. I'm going to start putting my top guns out there almost every other opportunity and seeing if we can at least net one, because you build from one upward.
Well, after that five-minute major for fighting, Chris Fratterigo back out on the rink.
Yep, Chris out there, and let's see what he can do. I mean, he's had a great opportunity to take a breather. Maxie just called him off. He's trying to match lines again.
Toe save right there. Stewart now with it for Mission. He's going to walk through one-on-one. Shot save, Hernandez.
Hey, you know, the exciting thing we talked a little bit about at halftime is December 3rd, our Midwest opener. We're going to see the Chicago Carnage, the Buffalo Excitement, Motor City Assault, a new team called the New York Rock and Rollers, or New York, New Jersey Rock and Rollers, and hopefully the New Jersey Grizzlies all battling it out from Novi, Michigan on December 3rd.
Sounds cold.
Michigan is cold, but the greatest thing about Michigan is Timmy Hortons. My favorite place. Just like you were at Epcot, Timmy Hortons is mine.
Well, I didn't say that was exactly my favorite. It was just a long walk.
Epcot's a great time.
Well, this big guy doesn't get around too much anymore, so that's a long walk. But the Magic Kingdom was magical. Animal Kingdom was a kingdom, and I tell you, those Hollywood studios felt like I was in Hollywood, so gotta love Disney.
I love the New York set they have there. Halloween time is pretty cool.
All right, now back to the action here is Mission setting up behind the Arizona net. And a miscued pass by Sean Riley happens to go all the way back.
Sean Riley's mustache got in the way of that one. He kind of put a little too much mustard on it, and it didn't go to the intended target, which was a penalty box door.
Well, here's Rodriguez now. Mission a three-on-two opportunity. Rodriguez glove down, flashing the leather there. Eric Hernandez.
One of the great things, again, is a deceptive speed. He comes in full speed. He cuts back on the heels a little bit, cuts across the grain. Both defensemen, because they're a little inexperienced, back in on top of their goaltender, allowing him that time to snap that puck off.
Hernandez standing tall, taking all Mission shots. Now Rizak with it for Mission. They're going to walk back with it across to Massey now. Jonathan Massey now going to walk back and kill the last hopeful minute and 40 off the clock. Massey being patient now. Over to Rizak. Rizak ahead, deflected away by the Arizona forecheck. Arsenal now pestered by the Mission forecheck as they play the body.
Well, again, you see the Mission once again proving their dominance both physically and with puck control. They just move the puck so well. And they're so big and brawny. We just saw those two great hits.
Now Mission again with possession in the offensive zone. Riley throws a tester in front, and Hernandez steers it away. Now an opportunity thrown back across for Riley. Riley going to look in front, and Hernandez is going to deflect that away. Under a minute to go now. Arizona, another opportunity, and just a bit high over the net.
Boy, did he buzz the tower there. We got a jet, American Airlines, coming in for landing.
That's a negative Ghost Rider. The pattern was full. Hernandez stopping all comers now in the second half. 30 seconds left to play. Mission up 4-0.
Mission is going to go a perfect 6-0 on our season here. And right now, Arizona and Anaheim are going to be battling out for second place.
Now on the closing seconds with 20 to go. This is Stewart to take there for Mission. Now played back for Rizak in the final 10. Mission will go 6-0. As Stewart plays the last puck for Rizak, and it's over. Ladies and gentlemen, I want to thank you for watching all the live coverage of RollerHockeyTV.net. After this commercial, we're going to send it back to the studio.
Joaquin Chavira is a member of the LA Palma Cyclones pro team and a member of the U.S. national hockey team. Joaquin was diagnosed 6 weeks ago with cancer and is in a battle right now and was unfortunately not able to make this trip. The Walk Strong Foundation was created in an effort to help Joaquin Chavira and his family during these tough times. With the help from everyone in our hockey community, this fight can be won. By purchasing a Walk Strong t-shirt, bracelet, or donation, you can make a difference. For more info, find us on Facebook.com or walkstrong.org. Our goal is to help this player once again return to the sport he loves.
All right, Adam Steele, Doug Jones back here in the Major League Roller Hockey and RollerHockeyTV.net studio. Jonesy, what did you think of the action tonight?
Two games, obviously. The first one, the Anaheim Bullfrogs, had a little bit of a confidence booster they definitely needed against the Hollywood Dream. You know, again, I'm going to say about the Hollywood Dream is that the players like Eitan Chavera, Subraj Najjar, Kevin Adams, Zach Walters, you know, if you're going to commit to play, be here. Don't commit to play and then leave your teammates out to dry. It's not fair to these guys that show up and really work hard and they're counting on you to be here. So my only message is we all know Eitan Chavera is a world-class athlete. I think Eitan is one of the best players in the sport. But you know what? Be here. If you're going to say you're going to show up, do your teammates that justice and make sure you show up and be here, participate, be part of what you're doing. As far as the Bullfrogs go, I mean, great night for them. The addition of Chris Ellis, he did a fantastic job. We saw Mike Henley, the new addition, played pro ice in Germany. He's here. Another great opportunity for him to make his debut. Mission got a little, not Mission, but the Anaheim Bullfrogs got a little bigger and a little more physical.
Well, I have to say with, you know, Chris Ellis, Joey Larickia, Charlie Middleton, Brian Steiner, they definitely have the total package and they are looking sharp.
Oh, absolutely. And then the Mission Axiom. I can sit here all night and just talk about how good they are, how deep their depth runs. Just looking at that bench again, you know, they bring in some additional players to deal with some of the guys who are out in Hong Kong running hockey schools right now. Tommy Neer steps up to the plate, does a great job. We see players that we normally don't see garner a lot of rink time, like James Stewart, play a lot more tonight. Great job. Tommy Tyler, once again, proverbially showing both ends of the rink. He's one of the best players out there. I mean, Mission is so deep in talent that everybody can get the job done. And I really think this season, if these other teams want to have a chance at beating Mission, they have to bring their A game and be consistent in what they do.
Well, speaking of A game, I think A game is what they brought in contact, just not unfortunately with puck control. I think Arizona was a little thwarted this afternoon.
Well, the Arsenal had a great afternoon. They won their first two games, and they come into the third game, and they're looking for the opportunity. They're playing a much more deeper team in depth than they have. When I say depth, not talking about bench size, I'm talking in players that have that kind of game experience. And with Arizona, it's just a matter of they're gradually improving each week they come here. So when we see them December 10th here again, I think we're going to see an even better Arizona Arsenal than we saw tonight. And they're going to give Mission a run for the money because they'll learn from their mistakes. Dan Maxwell's the type of coach. He's going to go back to these guys. He's going to talk to them. He's going to give them some intuition on what they're doing wrong. Too much time and space. What I saw tonight, Arizona gives up too much time and space to a Mission. You can't do that. It's a deadly thing. Mission will take advantage of that, capitalize it. We saw it time and time again. I think Chris Hernandez played out of his mind tonight for the Arsenal. That should have been an 8-0 game. Chris kept his teammates into that game.
I'll definitely have to give them props. What do we got coming up in a couple of weeks?
December 3rd, we are opening our Midwest season. We're looking forward to it. Should be a very exciting time. We'll be live from Novi, Michigan. And then we're back here December 10th, where Rob Laurie, number one, will have his jersey retired. And Joe Cook has told me personally he's looking forward to that opportunity.
Is it going to be a retirement ceremony or a roast?
I think Joe is going to get back at Rob a little bit. Actually, Rob was pretty good. It was, I think Chad Siebel when he came out. Chad is funny. He's always been a funny guy, but I think it's a great opportunity for these guys to come out and have a little fun with it. So December 10th here, Rob Laurie, number one, will be retired.
All right. Well, stay tuned again to MLRH.com for all the standings, up-to-date stats, and about all of our broadcasts coming up December 3rd and December 10th. That's Novi, Michigan, and right back here in Irvine, December 10th, Rob Laurie night. Stay tuned and check out all the replays at RollerHockeyTV.net. For Doug Jones, Adam Steele saying good night from Irvine.